Hello. I'm Ricardo Montalban, and yes, I'm an actor. If you're looking for a career where you can earn a six-figure salary and get the opportunity of wearing suits, just like this one, then come see me at the Ricardo Montalban School of Fine Acting, where I give personal instruction in theater, film, commercials, mime, musicals, and of course, television.
What light through yonder window breaks?
What light through yonder window?
What light through yonder
what
window?
What light
through? What light through yonder window breaks?
Through yonder window
through
breaks.
Yonder window breaks.
What light through
what
yonder
light
window
through
breaks?
Yonder window breaks.
Yes. To be a good salesman, you must be a good actor.
Sweet, nutritious, and crunchy.
Crunchy. Nutritious and crunchy.
Nutritious and crunchy.
Yes.
To me, singing is acting.
Tomorrow.
To any actor, movement is so important.
No, Gene. Straight and tall, always straight and tall. What are you talking about, kid? You saw money.
You don't understand, Charlie. I could have had class. I could have been a somebody instead of a bum. Which is what I am. Let's face it, Charlie.
Yes. Yes, at the Ricardo Montalban School of Fine Acting, acting is our most important product.
For more information, call toll-free 1-555-11...
No, 555...
555-1137. Call today.
Yes.
Tired of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. SCTV is now on the air. Starring John Candy, Joe Flaherty, Eugene Levy, Andrea Martin, Rick Moranis, Catherine O'Hara, and Dave Thomas. Television like you've never seen it before. This is the SCTV Television Network.
Good day. How to do it fast, because there's a whole show.
Shh, don't say good day.
Good day. How's it going? I'm Bob McKenzie. And this is my brother, Doug.
How's it going, Nick?
We got a real good show for you, and, like, we don't have a lot of time because it's, like, a real big topic, okay?
Okay,
today, the topic is, like, microwave ovens.
Okay. Okay. Like, first of all, first thing to know about microwave oven is never put a cat in because they blow up, eh?
Okay, the topic is, like, whether you should cook back bacon in a microwave or like this. Well, we know which way to cook it, right?
Okay.
This way, okay?
Where do you plug a back bacon oven, microwave oven, sorry.
A back bacon oven.
Okay, I'm slowing down the show, eh? Go ahead. Sorry, everyone.
Well, now, like,
I forget. Wait, you never put a back bacon in a microwave oven because, like, if you do...
It'll blow up, right?
Yeah. Right. No, cats. Back bacon's okay, as long as you don't put in foil. Foil will
burn. But it's better fried.
But don't put in bread. Bread goes soggy, eh? We put in this bread, and look, this isn't the one. It was this bread. Yeah, this bread went soggy.
Okay, and like never put a beer...
You put the wrong bread on top. You embarrass me in front of everybody.
Okay, and never put a beer in the microwave, because it'll boil. Okay, that's the show for today, so good day.
Hope you learned a lot about microwaves.
The show's over.
Oh.
Boy.
You know? Shouldn't have put the hard bread on top. It completely blew it.
Yeah,
me.
Well...
I'm supposed to say how bread is soggy, eh? Look at this. You can stand it up, eh? It's like not soggy at all.
Listen to that clunk.
Feel how hard
it is.
It's real hard, eh?
Come on, eh?
This is hard bread.
Yeah, look, it's not going to dent that head of yours.
Yeah, it didn't leave much of a scar in your noggin either.
And now, from the SCTV Film Archive, Gangway for Miracles, featuring Edith Prickly in her film debut.
And if that barking bird don't sing, Mama's gonna buy you a diamond ring. And if that diamond ring don't shine, Mama's gonna buy you some valentines.
Now I know the fine work you did with Helen Keller. Yeah. But me daughter's no more than a wild animal. You can't communicate with her.
She's wild, all right, but she's not hopeless. I can get through to her. Just gonna take a lot of love, understanding, and patience. Hello, dear. She's got spirit, all right. I got a broken jaw. I better get started right away, Captain.
Arr!
For the salad. Now, how the hell are you gonna eat your entree? Champagne. Expensive crystal. Art and a leg. There now. You see, she learns, Captain. All right, dear. Which wine do you use with your meat? Red or white? Red or white?
Arr, it's hopeless.
I don't know the meaning of the word, Captain.
All right, Captain. I want you to lock us in your daughter's bedroom. No matter what you hear going on, I do not want you to open that door. Now we get down to business.
All right, Miss Sullivan. You have 2 days. 2 days to perform a miracle.
Let's go to the hop. Let's go to the hop. Let's go to the hop. Let's go.
Whoa! But Jitterbug. Juniors! Ah! How am I gonna get through to her? Language, child. We're talking language here. Language will set you free. Ah!
With you
is to fight fire with fire.
Miss Sullivan, what the hell is going on up there?
Peach pie, Dan. miracle. Hiya, Cap. You think this is a miracle? Wait till you see the miracle it takes to clean up that room. Just kidding. You think I did my job a little too well, Cap?
Miss Sullivan, I don't believe it, hearing her talk like this. Why, I tell you, it's music to me ears.
Is that right, dear? Well, wait till you hear this, Cap. That's nothing. Give me an A, won't you, mad dog? Oh, mock.
Yeah.
A.
Yeah.
Bird.
Yeah.
A mockingbird.
Yeah.
Everybody have heard. I'm gonna buy you a mockingbird. And if that mockingbird don't sing, then mama's gonna buy you a diamond ring. And if that diamond ring don't shine, well, then mama's gonna break it.
Coming soon, Johnny LaRoe's career is on the line.
Hey, what are you doing messing with my parking space?
I heard you went over budget on Polynesian Town.
Oh, you did you? What? You said that crane shot was going to cost 10 big ones. I thought you meant 10 bucks.
Now, look, I'm giving you one camera, one microphone, and you do the rest.
That's impossible.
It's your last shot.
I'll do it.
Good evening, and welcome to Doorway to Hell. I'm your host, Lin Yi Tang. And tonight, live on SCTV, the bizarre and incredible story of the man who lived in the box. Who was this man? Why did he live in a box? How did he get there? Would he have to stay in this box forever? Was this box, in fact, hell? Uh-oh. I gave away the ending.
Keep going.
Keep going. Why? I gave away the ending.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did. I said the box was hell. A man did not know he died, see? And the box was hell. Ooh. I ruined this whole episode. I'm sorry, everybody. I'm especially sorry to the cast. They worked so hard. Please come over and take a bow.
No!
Please, come over and take a bow so the audience can see you.
Take a bow? What are you doing?
Come
on.
Let them see you. This
is see me.
This
is your
reward. You must be seen.
I've had it with your thing. 2 weeks of rehearsal and you blow it.
Take it easy.
You blew it. We rehearsed for 2 weeks.
I'm sorry.
It's a matter.
Please, everybody, I'm sorry.
It's all right. We can do another take.
What do you mean another take? This is live. Are we getting paid for this? I want to know right off the bat.
There will be some money.
What do you mean some money?
We can work that out later.
Work it out? Are we getting paid or not?
We're getting paid for this thing.
Sid,
we're getting paid.
Sid.
Yes.
I wash my hands of the whole thing. Talk to my agent.
2 weeks and overtime and those meal penalties. I didn't know this was live free.
They hate me. Oh. I'm sorry, everybody. Please forgive me. Just because I made a mistake. I'm not infallible. Everybody makes mistakes. Anyway, next week on Doorway to Hell, we have an incredible story. Better than this one. It's the story of the woman whose head began to grow. A sad story of a woman who wore this hat and couldn't get through doorways or even get her hair off.
Tank.
You see, it was an enchanted
hat. Get over here before
hat.
You blow another one.
Good. Anyway, join me then. Good night.
I want
that money right now. I'm sorry. Oh. Chat with the mayor of Mellonville, Tommy Shanks. Tonight's topic, gun control.
Hi. How are you? I'm doing pretty good myself. All my back went out last week, but other than that, pretty good. Better than any television show, that's for sure. More entertaining, too. The way they crack and pop like that. Can't beat it. I was listening to the radio the other day. It said there's more handguns on the face of the earth than there are baseball cards. Where do they come up with those facts? Well, good night.
You've been listening to Mayor Tommy Shanks. From the dawn of man to the far reaches of the universe, man's second greatest tool is and always will be the brain.
Good evening. Tonight on Brain, a look at function and control. What part of the brain controls what function? And if so, has the media reported it honestly? All of this and more tonight on Walter Cronkite's Brain. Walter?
Thank you, David. And good evening, even though it's morning here for me. Today will be following me through a typical day to examine the two hemispheres of my brain and finding... Get out of the shot, please. And finding whether you need both hemispheres to get by or whether you can get by with just one. On a beautiful day like today, a Saturday. So off we go to the golf course to give the old right side of the brain a rest. When you spend the entire week thinking about space in the universe, a Saturday is a time to let the left side of the brain take over. This is my car. ...454 cubic inches of power.
Cronkite's brain is like yours and mine. A complex, colorless cortex floating in a globe filled with spinal fluid, directing the muscles to fulfill all the daily functions, controlling and responsible for communication, providing awareness and abstract thought, and recording it all indelibly and permanently in the media.
Sorry, David. I almost forgot to pick you up.
Just like you almost forgot your clubs, moron. Part one, memory.
So Richard Nixon becomes the first president in United States history to resign from office. That's the way it is this day, August the 9th, 1974.
His words, one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind, will immortalize this day in the annals of history. David Brinkley, NBC News.
And so Dwight Name and I is now reelected by an even wider margin over Adlai Stevenson in 1952, begins his second term in the White House.
On this, the blackest day in U.S. economic history, which saw the collapse of Wall Street, and the end of an age of prosperity.
Assassination of Archduke Ferdinand and Sarah Jabo signals the beginning of the Great War. That's the way it is. This day, June 28, 1914, I'm Walter Cronkite. Good night.
Walter Cronkite's brain is not unlike mine. For scientists now claim that all of us, when under hypnosis or extreme stress, can participate in what is called race memory, or the genetic transfer of memory from one generation to another. Here, young Walter is remembering his early days on the planet Krypton with his father, Jor-El Cronkite.
My son, you will travel far to a distant planet in another galaxy. Their ways on that planet will differ remarkably from ours, but you must record them accurately and honestly without bias. That's just the way it is. What's up? You must hurry, my son. There is much to be done. Who are you?
I am an image of your son's future. I am here to tell you not to send him to the planet Earth.
Why not?
Because the planet Earth is already cluttered with too many reporters, turning human history into a media wasteland. There is no need for young Waltor.
But Waltor, with his powers, could be the greatest reporter of them all.
If I can keep young Waltor from leaving the planet Krypton, I will be the greatest reporter of them all.
You'll never leave here alive!
me, Jor-El. I am just a part of the baby Waltor's brain, a part known as the imagination.
Can you imagine what it would have been like if we'd had to play the full 18 holes without a caddy, David?
Sorry, Waltor, I wasn't listening. I was daydreaming about something.
You're using the wrong side of your brain. You're supposed to use the left side today.
In some ways, Cronkite's brain is different than yours and mine.
Give me a hand with these clubs, David.
Where you and I might perceive a game of golf as healthy competition.
Oh, sorry.
Cronkite seizes the opportunity to unleash his mercurial sense of devilment to ruin what could be an afternoon of fun.
Oh. What's the matter? Can't you take it?
Walter, I can understand you wanting to win, but acting like this shows a remarkable lack of ingenuity.
David, look out there.
Walter, that kid is you.
No, it can't be. This is all a nightmare.
Walter, isn't it true that when you meet your doppelganger, the two of you cannot exist in the same space and time?
Oh!
I've been waiting for you, Waltor. I knew your father, Jor-El Cronkite. He was a good man. Come, there is much to learn.
Hey, you moron!